And he brought back.
What do you
preach? One second, bro. And he brought back the Izzah to the Muslims, the honor to the Muslims. I preach Islam.
Islam.
Yeah, yeah. And the Sunnah.
The one Islam of Allah, yeah? Huh? The one Islam of Allah.
Yeah, the Islam of Muhammad alayhi salam that he came with.
And his Ashab and Ahlul Bayt,
yeah? Yeah, no, sorry, you're right.
That's it, yeah?
Yeah, yeah, alhamdulillah. You happy with that?
Yeah, everyone's happy with that.
MashaAllah, Allah. But proper, no, Ahlul Bayt Shia one.
Why not Shia one, bro?
No, what's wrong with this one?
The Shia one?
No, the Shia one is not that one.
What's wrong with it?
I tell you what's wrong with it. Firstly, let me finish with him, and you'll be the next.
You finish with him, bro.
No. Brother, you have to calm down.
I haven't finished with him.
Yeah, you have to respect for the people. Yeah. Listen, so what we say to you, akhi, so you can be Hanafi, Maliki, Salafi, Maliki, Salafi, Shafi'i, Salafi.
So, talking about Shia, this Shia, that.
Brother, you know, if you don't like it here, then you have to go outside, brother. Here?
Yeah,
because here we speak with.
I've had enough.
Because respect. Like okay, yeah.
Respectfully, you're the one that brought it up.
Yeah, I know.
No.
I'm not being disrespectful, bro.
Ah, halas, brother, we're going to talk, inshallah. Yeah. Halas. So, what we said to you, there is no poor difference between the two. Makansh. انت انت من سنت وجه مش بعيد علي انا من الكميل ما شاء الله تهلا حبيبي يا ها بفودا يس اخي واش نيم خويا
ما بابا
واش نيم
ماي نيم از عبد الهادي
ما شاء الله بيوتيفول شمسي
عليك السلام
حياك
الله عليك
بارك الله فيك
الله يوفقك الله يحفظك
امين
ترى ادعي لك انا دعوه خاصه
جزاك الله خير بارك الله فيكم جزاك الله خير يو سيد اباوت واتس رونج وذ الشيعه سو اف يو ستدي هيستوري
لسن لسن دونت فيديو مي جست فيديو شمسي
يا اوكي دور If you study history, Shi'ism is something came after when Abdullah ibn Saba, who was a Jewish man, he entered to Islam.
Do you have proof for this?
Yeah, even from your books, from Shia books.
From Shia books, it
says? Yeah, it speaks about Abdullah ibn Saba.
Maybe there were some people who wrote these books. Maybe there were some people who wrote these books that may take a rashwa, may take a bribe.
Rashwa, yeah, okay.
May take a bribe, may take
Yeah, rashwa, someone. Rashwa.
Yeah.
So what's that?
Do you think this possible?
Yeah,
the
that's
people what. Who wrote these books.
Yeah,
you I believe. Think it's possible, the ones that are printed, that they took some money.
No doubt, know? I believe what happened. So let me finish with this, akhi. Yeah? When Abdullah ibn Saba saw Islam was powerful and cannot be defeated in a war, he came with this ideology of Al Khilafah has to be after to the Ahl Bayt. Because he was a Jewish who believed that Musa, والسلام, the Khilafah goes back to his family.
Has anyone seen this, brother?
Brother, I have to finish. Okay.
Sorry.
You know, brother.
Sorry.
Abdul Hadi, may Allah give us hidayah all
the
past.
Forgive me.
No problem, akhi. It's not conditional to see someone to know he exists. Because you haven't seen Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, I haven't seen Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, but we know he exists. So it's not conditional, by the way. Secondly, like I said, from Shia sources, Sunni sources. Thirdly, when you look at Shia sources and look at Shi'ism, Shi'ism is not based upon the Quran.
But why can't we understand the Quran in a different way? So for example, when it says قُلْ يَا عِبَادِ الَّذِينَ أَسْرَفُوا عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ لَا تَقْنُطُوا مِنْ رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ جَمِيعًا إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ
nah.
So then, does that mean the Shia will never be forgiven?
No, I never said that. Even okay. Atheists if make tawbah,
exactly.
they Allah forgive them.
Ahsan, Ahsan. So then why does the Shia have to be out of the Islam?
Okay.
Why can't they be with the Islam?
Because the Shia, firstly, I'm not saying every Shia person, okay? Let me be specific. Shia.
What does Shia mean?
Before Shia.
What does Shia mean?
But I'm Arab, I have Shia. Shia means a tashayyu.
No, follower. It means a follower of.
Tashayyu means someone, an aida, a helper,
yeah,
follower, yes.
Follow, yeah.
شيعته Ibrahim. Understand
Ahsan.
That? So, you made me forget.
Abdul Hadi.
No, with the point I was going to mention.
Sorry.
La hawla wa quwwata illa billah.
Bismillah.
No, any Shi'i believe the Quran has been changed. And he believes that it's permissible to say al-madad ya Ali, to pray to Ali. And this man is a mushrik, no doubt about that. What do you think about someone saying al-madad ya Ali?
Ahsant.
Abdul Hadi, I'm a question with you.
If someone prays to Imam Ali and thinks Imam Ali is God,
No. What do you think about someone saying
he's outside of Islam?
No, listen carefully.
Ya Ali, do you know, let me explain that to you.
You're not answering. I said, what do you think about someone says al-madad ya Ali? No, ya Ali, al-madad ya Ali.
Ya Ali madad, they say.
Yeah, same thing.
So. Let me explain to that to you.
Yeah.
So for example, let's say I have a cousin, yeah?
Yeah.
And this is real life. My cousin owns a vaping company. A vaping company, there's a lot of people in the world who vape, yeah? You need to get flavor, yeah? But you're out of flavor, you don't have no money in your pocket, bro, you're broke, yeah? But my cousin sells vape, yeah? You can come to me, tell him, listen, I know Hadi, yeah? I know Abdul Hadi, yeah? And he'll sort it out for you, cheaper price, maybe for whatever you got, maybe for one of your dishdasha, nice one. You go swap it, he'll give you a vape price. you know? So when people say Ya Ali, they're not saying Ya Ali as if Ya Ali is Allah, bro. Never, never, never. Allah, wal'ayadu billah, yeah? They're saying, listen, Ya Ali Madad, oh Ali, I know, you know what? Shuhada are still with Allah, bro. They're alive, living forever, bro. Shuhada. What's the ayah in the Quran about the shuhada?
Carry on.
يرزقون مع ربهم.
فلاحسبن الذين قتلوا في سبيل الله
أمواتا. What I'm trying to say, like even تشيع, yeah, it can, you don't have to be Shia to be a Shia, bro. You can follow the Prophet and you follow the goodness of the Prophet and the goodness of the Prophet came from all of them. Yeah, it came from all of the people around him because he lived
Ali,
the most beautiful
Abdadi, life. Abdadi, you digressing now.
That's why we said, let's go back to the point.
Let's go back to the point. Let's go back
so
to the main point.
Allah, yeah, I know Ali's close to Allah.
Yeah, let's go back to the main. Understand what he said. You gave the example of
Allah,
you gave the example of this, what they call it, vape. I don't even know what they call it. Anyway, vape, yeah? You said if you need a flavor and you know the guy who owns the company.
Yeah.
Firstly, this is a bad example in comparison
why,
to Allah.
Bro?
I'll tell you why. Firstly, Allah is not in need of no one between him and his creation.
But we need him.
Allah, you speak, you know, let me speak. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he can hear you, but the person who is in a company in Iraq or Morocco and you're in Britain, he cannot hear you. Allah can hear you wherever you are. So you don't need to go to Ali. Rather, what Allah said in the Quran. That's why.
No,
let me to finish. Let me finish. What Allah said in the Quran. What Allah said in the Quran, Abdul Hadi. That's what I said, Shia. Well, you know what I said? I said Shia. If you listen carefully, Abdul Hadi. Well, you have to answer, Abdul Hadi. I came from a background very similar to Shiism, Sufiya. You know? So I'm not just attacking something I don't know. I know very well. Abdul Hadi, Allah sent the Quran. وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ أُجِيبُ دَعْوَةَ الدَّاعِ إِذَا دَعَانِ. He didn't say go to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Say go to Ali. Where he said, call upon me.
Yeah.
Another verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَقَالَ رَبُّكُمْ رَبُّكُمْ وَقَالَ رَبُّكُمْ أُدْعُونِي أَسْتَجِبْ لَكُمْ إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يَسْتَكْبِرُونَ عَنْ عِبَادَتِي سَيَدْخُلُونَ جَهَنَّمَ دَاخِرِينَ. Let me finish, Abdul Hadi. Barakallahu feek. I'm saying Allah said in the Quran that if my servant call upon me, and the dua is a nida in Arabic, Arabian nida. So when you say Ya Ali al-Madad, al-Madad, in the meaning of it.
Not al-Madad. You say Ya Ali Madad.
Al-Madad, yeah, al-Madad. What is the Madad?
Al-Madad. Madad. Ya Ali Madad.
Brother, al-Madad mean when you are in a time of hardship,
yeah,
and you need help.
Yeah.
And Allah said about the situation like that,
yeah,
look how you oppose the Quran. Allah said, أَفَمَنْ يُجِيبُ الْمُضْطَرَّ إِذَا دَعَاهُ.
Continue.
No, brother, this is
continue,
respect.
Continue, bro.
No, this is respect.
That's disrespect.
No.
Continue.
No. I'm reciting a verse.
Wallahi, I'm listening to you.
Forget about Shamsi. It's a verse, you know.
He
just told him hello. He hugged you.
Sorry.
How many times did I say hello to him?
Forgive me.
It's about verse.
Forgive me, Shamsi.
Anyway, listen, brother Abdul Hadi. So Allah said in the Quran, who's going to help, who's going through the hardship, is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So you have to understand, Abdul Hadi, a dua is for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Anyone directs any act of worship to other than Allah is a mushrik. And Allah said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَغْفِرُ أَن يُشْرَكَ بِهِ وَيَغْفِرُ مَا دُونَ ذَلِكَ لِمَن يَشَاءُ. I'm reading the verse, bro. Let me finish the verse, bro.
Finish the verse.
Yeah, let me finish it, please. So Allah said, Allah does not forgive anyone that associate partners with him. He forgives less than that to whom he wills. So dua, nida, yeah, in a time of hardship is a dua, and that should be directed to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wa salam said to Ibn Abbas, Ya ghulam, idha sa'alta fas'alillah wa idha sta'anta fasta'in billah. And Allah said, Iyaka na'budu wa iyaka nasta'in. You alone will worship and you alone will seek aid. So my brother, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned about the kuffar Quraysh, إن الذين اتخذوا من دونه أولياء ما نعبدهم إلا ليقربون إلى الله زلفا إن الله يحكم بينهم يوم القيامة فيما كانوا فيه يختلفون. What you just said, exactly what the Kuffar Quraysh said. The Kuffar Quraysh said, we know that pure, we need someone to bring us closer to Allah, who are Isa, the angels, the righteous people, and Allah called them Kuffar for doing this. That's in the Quran.
But in Prophet Muhammad's time,
the alayhi salatu wasalam, yeah.
Alayhi salatu wasalam, sorry bro, you know I'm a Sayyid, so I don't need to
You're a Sayyid?
I'm a Sayyid, yeah, from the Shia, from the line of Imam Musa al-Kadhim.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam, bro, sorry man, do I have to say it every time?
Every time,
sorry.
No, not every time, that's every time. But you don't say this at all.
I mean,
we have to remind you.
In my heart, I'm saying it.
But we don't hear you, brother.
I'm saying.
But you see, Ahl Sunnah love Nabi Sallam. We have said.
Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, Muhammad.
Aye.
Yeah, Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala Muhammad. Yeah. Either way, he says in the Quran also, Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Those words. Allah is Rahman, Allah is Rahim always. Now, those two meanings have a different meaning. The Rahman is one meaning, the Rahim is one meaning. You know them. Simple, back to basics Islam, yeah? But if I was to tell you why I bring the vape example up, because intercession, you know about intercession? What is intercession in Arabic?
Shafa'a.
Shafa'a, ahsan. Shafa'a, why do the Shia do it? Is it, do you think because maybe we want to go and worship Ali, grab onto the thing and be like, Ya Ali, you're God? No, bro.
Okay, why Kuffar Quraysh or Kuffar? One second. Why Kuffar Quraysh or Kuffar? Akhi, please. Let's see, listen. Why Kuffar Quraysh or Kuffar? Why Allah call Kuffar Quraysh Kuffar? Do you know why? I'll help you, Brother Abdul Hadi.
I want
to
know why.
Mashallah, good.
Because listen. Of the Quran, they can be taken as different interpretations.
No. The Quran is clear. That's verse clear. Allah said.
You know,
let me finish. Tell you why.
Who's going to. Bro, who wrote the Quran?
Abdul Hadi.
Who wrote the Quran?
Abdul Hadi before wrote.
When Rasulullah was revealing.
Alayhi salatu wa salam.
Yeah. Alayhi salatu wa salam. Who was there writing it with
him? I'll tell you after.
Imam Ali and the Ashab, the Abu Bakr, the Umar, the Uthman,
right.
And the people around him, bro.
My brother, before you digress, the point here is.
I'm not digressing.
No. A kuffar Quraysh. Do you know why the kuffar? Allah said the Quran. وَلَا إِن سَأَلْتَهُمْ مَنْ خَلَقَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ لَيَقُولُنَّ اللَّهِ. Allah mentioned the Quran, the Kuffar of Quraysh.
Let me
finish.
I agree.
Abdul Hadi, let me finish. The Kuffar of Quraysh, they never believe the angels are Allah. They never believe righteous people are Allah. They never believe some of them Jesus Allah. They believed they are intercessors, shufa'a. Yet Allah called them Kuffar. They never believe the Malaika are Allah. Allah mentioned, after let me finish, this is a Tawheed issue. This Allah is right here, bro. We don't joke about
but
that.
You're trying to
let me finish. Let me finish. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned that that's why I said about Shafa'a, Shufa'a. واتخذوا من دون الله ما لا ينفع. واتخذوا من دون الآية. عاودوا باش ترجم. والذين اتخذوا من دون الله. قالوا هؤلاء شفعاؤنا عند الله. They said they are our شفعاء عند الله. Allah yet called them kuffar, even though they never believed the angels are Allah. What they believe they are shufa'a. There's two types of shafa'a. There's shafa'a which is manfiyya, and shafa'a musbata. Shafa'a which is valid, like you, in front of me, Abdul Hadi. I said, Abdul Hadi, akhi.
Let me finish.
Abdul Hadi. Abdul Hadi, akhi. I said, I need to push my car. You are alive and you are able. I said, come help me. This is called shafa'a. Well, Abdul Hadi, you know this guy? Can you help me? No problem. But to come to someone who's dead and you say, Ali, can you help me? Or ask Allah to help me?
No. The ayah of the shuhada in the Quran. You said the Quran is clear.
But Allah said,
Allah. The ayah about the shuhada.
Well, Allah said,
Yurzaqun. Something about the
Quran. Ahya'un 'inda rabbim.
Yeah.
Finish it?
I don't know, you finish it.
Yurzaqun. No, yarzuqun.
Yeah,
yurzaqun. Do you know what it means?
Yeah, where?
Yurzaqun.
Alam al barzakh.
No. Yurzaqun means Allah give them. No, they give.
Alam al
barzakh. Yeah.
So
no, wait. Step by step.
Me and you understand barzakh.
No, wait, before barzakh.
We've never been in barzakh.
Abdul Hadi, do you understand? Allah mentioned in the same ayah that Allah give them. No, they give. Why you go to people who Allah give them? I'm Algerian, by the way. I'm from North Africa.
Algeria,
Morocco.
I shout as well, but
no, not like Algerian Moroccans.
I'm next to you.
We're North Africans, we shout too much.
They have mics, we're good.
No, we're not like us. That's our nature.
Like four mics.
You know, even Imam Malik, give you fa'ida, you know. Because Imam Malik, rahimahullah, because he was very strong and he was very loud, they said he was from Al-Maghrib. Because Al-Maghrib don't know about that. Anyway, the point here is, I have passions, you know. Passionate.
It's good.
Alhamdulillah. My point
like
here is, Abdul Hadi, my point is, Abdul Hadi, the point here, brother, may Allah guide us to truth, may Allah bless you, my brother.
Inshallah.
My point here is, akhi, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned that we have to call upon Him directly. You know, Do you understand that?
Ya Allah.
For, that's it.
May Allah give us true guidance.
As for Shia, if they make a tawbah and follow the Quran and the Sunnah.
But what's the
tawbah? Repent to Allah from
shirk. Does that mean we need to follow the, and you start praying like you and do everything like you?
Well, like me, like Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi
Wasallam. Yeah, okay. So that means we have to go back in history and learn how Prophet Muhammad used to pray.
We don't have
Prophet
to go back. We have it preserved. We have it preserved.
Okay, preserved. That's what I'm saying. From the beginning, I asked you, is it possible that people were paid? If I was to take off this Omega watch and go to my man and tell him, listen, bro, you write books, yeah? You're writing mad books out here, cousin. Listen, take this. It's worth peas.
You know more than?
It's worth peas. Bro, don't worry. It's worth peace. Listen, Omega is worth peace.
Wallahi, Abdullah, ya
sahi. Go show it on road. You'll make bare peas. You'll become a boss. You'll live a nice life. But I want you to put this in the book, change this in the book, and put that in the book. Can you do it or not? What would you say?
If he's a man of honor, we'll not do it.
He won't do it if he's a man of honor.
Yeah, khalas.
But if he's a man,
Bukhari
was
a man of honor.
If he's a man not of honor.
Bukhari was a man of honor. Muslim
I'm
man of honor.
I never said no names.
So why are you mentioning
I never
this stuff
said
here?
Names. I'm just giving you examples.
Veteran, why are you mentioning this stuff? There's no point mentioning
it. Is it possible?
It is possible, it's possible, and Allah exposed those guys.
Who are they? Where are they?
I told you, Kulaini.
No,
Kulaini, one of them.
They're all dead.
Allah exposed him that he
everyone's
lies.
Everyone's dead, though. Everyone's dead. We can't take them out of the grave and talk to them now.
I don't understand your point. I have respect. What is your point? I don't understand.
My point is, bro,
Prophet Muhammad is dead.
Islam is one.
Yeah, okay.
Islam is one. What does it mean? Submission.
No, just submission. No. Islam means...
If I shake your hand right now, I'm Shia, you're Sunni. Yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah?
So we become sushi.
Well, yeah, exactly. But where are you from? Where are you from?
I'm from Algeria.
I'm from Iraq.
Hayyallah
al-Iraq. Where's your madrasa? Is it like Shafi'i, Hanbali?
But are you home office or something?
No.
Where are you from?
Shafi'i, Hanbali.
I'm Hanbali.
Hanbali, okay.
I left my people. So Maliki, I left them.
Imam Ahmed bin Hanbal, who was his teacher?
A teacher, Muhammad bin Idris Shafi'i.
Okay, but
who is his teacher?
Do you agree?
Imam Malik bin Anas, his teacher.
Do you agree?
Wait. I'll tell you his teacher. The teacher of Ahmed bin Hanbal is Muhammad bin Idris Shafi'i. Muhammad bin Idris Shafi'i is
teacher. And all of their teachers,
who is that? Malik bin Anas.
Who is one of their teachers?
Malik bin Anas, his teacher, is Nafi'.
Who is all of their teachers?
Allah, let me finish, brother.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Allah, let me finish, I'll show you. Nafi', his teacher is Abdullah bin Umar. Abdullah bin Umar, his teacher, Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam received the revelation from Allah through Jibreel alayhi salam. That's our belief, that's our aqidah, goes back to Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. Take care of yourself, brother. May Allah guide us to the truth.
Bro,
salam alaikum.
Why are we finished?
What are we going to say tomorrow? What?
Nah, not tomorrow, but it's Sunday. Hello. It's the last Sunday I'm going to come here because I want to finish this argument. I don't want no more Shia Sunni arguments in the world.
No.
I don't want no more Shia Sunni.
Are you going to become Sunni?
No.
So you want to be...
I want to stick to my brand. I want you to stick to your one. But I said, may Allah
guide us.
Okay,
Abdul Hadi.
Abdul Hadi,
show me your belief from the Quran.
My belief from the Quran?
Yeah, show me. To call upon Ali, said Ali Ahmed.
I follow Imam Ali as number one, yeah?
Where's I ask you that. No, Quran? No. Show me. No, number one.
A'udhu billahi min ash-shaytan al-la'in ar-rajim. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim.
Abdul Hadi, number one, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa
sallam. Innama waliyukum Allah. Yeah, in sujood in Imam Ali, when there was a blind man coming in, or a charity
that's
man.
That's not Quran, that's not Quran.
It's in the Quran, bro.
Hey, show us where.
Get us in the Quran. Bro, I can't take
it out right. It's in the Quran. Let me recite it.
Innama waliyukum Allah wa rasooluhu wal-ladhina amanu al-ladhina yuqimuna as-salah. وَيُؤْتُونَ الزَّكَاةِ وَهُمْ رَاكِعُونَ. There's only one man in history.
Finish the ayah.
Finish it, bro. You finish it.
No, you're using it, not me.
Okay, that's the part I know.
That's the part of Shia.
You know
they
more.
Use half verse and another verse.
Well,
when you wali Allah wa Rasulah,
yeah.
You just finish the other verse, don't
know
it. So how this verse, no way.
Teach me.
Brother, if you say teach me, when you go to the class...
We don't have to change.
Abdul Hadi.
Teach me.
No. Abdul Hadi, when you go to the class, who speaks more, the teacher or the students?
Yeah, but the student needs to ask questions to learn.
No problem, but who speaks more, the teacher or student?
Teacher.
Khalas, let me speak more then. Okay. Now, I know I'm not trying to belittle him, but it's a reality. Because he can say, teach me, you know? So I will say to you, brother, look, that verse doesn't, if you recite that verse to Auntie Fatima in Algeria, in a village, or Auntie Fatima in Iraq in a village, she will never understand from that verse Allah is speaking about Ali. Firstly, إِنَّمَا وَلِيكُمُ اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا الَّذِينَ يُقِيمُونَ It's not الَّذِينَ جمع يُقِيمُونَ جمع الصلاة وَيُؤْتُونَ الزَّكَاةِ وَهُمْ رَاكِعُونَ In this verse, there is nowhere Ali, you have to go to the hadith which is fabricated. I'm asking you.
How is the Quran fabricated?
The Quran doesn't say there's a hadith. The hadith, not the Quran.
Oh, hadith. Okay,
Abdul Hadi, that verse. Abdul Hadi, that verse, rather, if you say Ali ibn Abi Talib was making a ruku' and he gave the khatim and he was listening to the people, Allah said.
But there was many Sahaba.
No, wait. That go against the verse in the Quran. So Ali opposed the Quran. Do you know why? Because Allah said, قَدْ أَفْلَحَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ الَّذِينَ إِيش هُمْ فِي صَلَاتِهِمْ خَاشِعُونَ No, الَّذِينَ يَسْمَعُونَ لِلنَّاسِ He's listening to people. That's
you're
the plan of Ali ibn Abi
Talib.
No, so that verse, again, show me your belief.
My belief,
you shake your hand too much. You're going to flip.
Because I love you, bro. I watch you online. I love you, bro. Wallah, bro. I love your passion for Islam, bro.
Alhamdulillah.
I love it, bro. And I don't want you to get annoyed with me because I'm Shia.
No, abadan, abadan.
Or speak about my people as if they're kuffar.
Salat.
Because I know there's...
Aqra al-ayah on top of the... Ya ayyuha al-ladhina amanu la tattahidu.
اليهود والنصارى أولياء بعضهم أولياء بعض.
What does yeah. Muslims believe? We're all as babies.
No,
we're all born Muslim.
Step by step, Ali. Abdul Hadi, please.
As babies,
is Shams Akhi, Abdul Hadi, I want to be patient with you, but step by step. Abdul Hadi, now you mention a verse, that verse does not substantiate your claim. So why would I say to you, Ali?
That's enough for me. That's enough for me.
Okay, so if someone coming now, that verse doesn't mean Ali.
Do you know why it's enough for me? Do you know why it's enough for me?
خلاص.
Because there was, listen, this is why it's enough for me. Let me say one more thing. Because the people in the mosque at the time, were trustworthy people, bro. They were
How do you know them?
They were the Sahaba, bro.
Who Sahaba said that?
They were Rasulullah's Sahaba, the people in the mosque at the
time. They said to you directly?
No, but it's not in the hadith. Your books are
No, Hakim is fabricated.
Yeah, fabricated.
Fabricated hadith.
As I said, that's why I said in the beginning. Rushwas and people giving bribes, that's very bad.
That's in Shia, that's why. Bad.
Why Shia, bro?
That's the reality, I'm not sure to speak Shia. That's in Sofia.
I don't give bribes.
Okay, do you believe in Mut'a?
I do.
Okay, be serious, yeah? If someone comes to you, Abdul Hadi, if someone comes to you, I'm not sure to suspect you because Mut'a, what Hassan said, Hussein said, if you do Mut'a once, you'll be with Hussein. I thought that was for me, the racist guy. If someone comes to you and says, allow me to have Mut'a with your sister, would you allow him?
Bro, if his intentions, it all depends on the intention. Does he want to marry my sister? Yeah? Because mut'a doesn't mean sex. Mut'a means...
I ask you that.
You're now mahram to each other. You are now mahram.
No, mut'a for you to have intercourse with a woman.
No, it's not.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
It's not, bro.
From your books.
I've got mut'a with a girl and not had mut'a sex with her.
No. Are you still married to her?
Bro, listen.
You divorced her.
Let me finish. How many mut'a you done? I got a loud voice. I'm Iraqi. You got Algerian. You got a loud voice. Bro, I just freed Palestine.
You just freed what?
I just freed Palestine. So leave me alone.
Where Palestine? Can
we freed it? I freed it.
You freed what?
In Musa, we freed it. So listen.
What?
Listen. Bro, listen. Listen to me. I'm gonna tell you something. If Palestine was to be free in the future,
I'm asking you, it would be me.
Huh? You know why? Because I'm the first person who wanted to take a bullet anywhere, bro.
Okay.
For you, for him,
There's no bullet here. I know. My question was
when
to you,
talk about
how
kuffar,
many
mut'a
you done? How many
mut'a? If I told you, listen, here's this gun, go kill the Shia, he's a kafir.
How many mut'a you done?
Would you do it, bro?
How many mut'a you done?
Bro, don't worry about me.
No, but
I'm a mudnib.
So mut'a is them?
No, I'm a mudnib. I've done many mistakes in my life.
No, how many mut'a you done? Okay, would you allow someone to have mut'a with your sister?
Depends on the intentions, bro.
What is intention mut'a?
Does he want to get married to her?
Yeah, for a few hours, few days.
No.
That's a mut'a. That's the version of mut'a. That's a mut'a. Mut'a to get married to a woman in a period of time.
It was introduced in war. It was introduced in war.
Abu Abdullah al-Shi'i will tell you what is mut'a.
Bro,
you see, you don't like it. I'm asking you.
It was introduced
like
in war by Prophet.
You see, he doesn't like it for his sister.
It was introduced.
He doesn't like it for his people. You don't like it for his sister.
Come, do
you
want to with my sister? Come. Do you want to?
No, I'm going to do mut'a.
And then we'll one on one after. Come.
One on one after. Fight.
Yeah, bro.
But mut'a is halal. Why are you going to fight me?
That's what I'm saying. It's halal.
Abu Hussein, I'm going to be with Hussein.
You got a problem with Shia. I'm going to one on one you after.
Why are you going to one on one?
You said you want to do mut'a with my sister.
Bro, don't
do
that.
I'm going to do a one on one with you.
Go. No.
I shake his hand already.
Brother.
Listen, brother.
You need to calm down.
I got time.
Don't tell me one
time. I need to cut.
You see, you get angry about mut'a. Because you know it's haram.
Okay, listen.
You know your foot on
this
haram.
Because
here it's anger. You say one to one. Brother, forget about one to one. I will say to you, look. My point was to you clearly. If you look definition of mut'a according to Shia sources, to marry a woman for a period of time, not a long time, then you can divorce her, then you can have mut'a again. Mut'a is not like a marriage when you have the intention to stay with the woman forever. Do you understand that? So what they did here, because the fitra, because the mut'a at the time Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was legislated out of necessity. You know,
why?
In a war.
Because they were in war.
That's it,
exactly.
That's it. Are we in a war now?
We agree.
Are we in a war
we
now?
We agree.
Are we in a war?
Bro, there could be a silent war going on.
So Allah, can you allow
there
you
could be a silent
no
war.
No problem. So you agree. No, Abu Abdullah, sorry. So you agree. So I have one. So you agree mut'a is a period of time.
Yes.
So would you allow for your sister to do that?
Yes, but only if she's going to marry him after without having sex. You can know how you
without having sex, how's gonna marry after playing football?
Mother has contracts. You can make a contract.
No, it's a period of time.
No, bro, no, you can no. make a contract.
Right, according to your books, you know your foot are speaking.
Bro, that's what don't talk to me like you know Wagwan.
Bro.
Don't talk to me like you know Wagwan.
Bro, stop shouting. Stop shouting.
You shouting at me, I'm shouting
bro,
at you.
Bro, stop shouting.
Let's be calm. You
know, I'll show you my camera. Don't let me show you my other face.
Yeah.
Seriously.
Bro. Don't talk to me like your heart.
Bro.
Don't talk to me like
go
your
away,
heart.
Go away, because I'm going to shut you there. Go away. Because you know what? People who show them your good face, they start taking a mic. You understand? What's this, man? But you know what I showed him? I showed him because of fitra. The fitra. You know, one brother told me this. I never thought about this. A brother told me, he called Yas al-Khabith. This Yas al-Khabith, he called him. He said, I will come Shi'i on the condition, allow me to have mut'a with your wife, or your sister, or your mother. He said, oh, he said, become angry. Why? Because they know that God angers the fitrah. The mut'a back then was out of necessity. Out of necessity at the time of war. That's why Prophet Muhammad, he said, it's haram.
Fi khayba,
do you know Ali ibn Abi Talib, you know, in Sahih al-Bukhari.
If
أبو عبد الله أبو عبد الله لا يقرأ القرآن لا يتكلم عربي لا فرنسي لا إنجليزي لا يوكراني لا شيء.
Why you not answer my question? Who's top the متعة?
I take care of self.
Come on. متعة تعال.
Anyway. السلام عليكم. Where is he? Where is he?
He's gone.
I forgot. I'm angry. Stop.
لا.
You see, look. It's Abu. You know, even he was getting rude to me. But I regret the way I spoke to him. Because the person gives da'wah, I should be patient.
Huh?
Alhamdulillah. Sometimes I blame myself. I thought, you know, I need to be more patient.